Another important part is that what you brought out is extremely good in the case of LCA. It is, of course, it is an excellent plane because unstably stable aircraft. It runs by the mission, though the pilot is giving a control. Because it is such an unstable system, you give 1 degree tilt, within 200 milliseconds it can go up to about 32 degrees. That means the swiftness or the speed with which it is going to react is large. Human being cannot control it. So you need to do that control. Consequently, what you do is you have to have a proper mechanism to do that. So we have today in the LCA, automatic takeoff and landing. Automatic takeoff is very much there. Flying safely is there. Today in the case of LCA, all the ski jumping in the naval version, it has been done automatically. And the flying in the level flight and safety has been done automatically. But then for landing, the last bit of thing is some more pseudo lights and other things had to be put, and we need to manage, see that we are landing properly. That's the only place that is pending. Even that, there is a smaller vehicle we are making called SWiFT in ADE Bangalore. By this time next year, we will have the SWiFT landing also.
What is the capability of SWiFT?
We don't have any capability other than proving the platform itself. We will use one of the engine of none other than nearby, and we'll simply fly for proving the vehicle that it can take off and land. We will not have more than 5 kg, 10 kg capability. That's not meant for proving any payload being dropped. It is mainly for proving the aircraft. The moment that is over, the full-blown AMCA is getting ready. That will use the dry Kaveri engine. But that's a bigger fellow. We want to start with the small and then go to the bigger. But Kaveri engine is available for that purpose. Where for drone KLA, we were denied for the engine, we do have a Kaveri substitute, though the power required is 52 kilotons. That is possible from Kaveri as against what is required about 80.
There's another capability which India has not shown, but we have, which is anti-satellite capability. What is the state of our anti-satellite weapons?
There are two aspects in that. One is that we need to know the location of the satellite as accurately as possible, so that we can send your missile or whatever the weapon that you would like to use close to that, because you cannot go there and search. We don't have that much energy and time. But all the missiles are generally going to be ballistic. That means they may not have a maneuvering capability. We must predict as accurately as possible from the ground. That is one aspect. After that, even when you accurately predict or detect that, you may have to take the vehicle. By the time it reaches, there could be some sort of a meandering. So there has to be another mechanism which will take it close to that. These are the two aspects. Both aspects we started working.
Some say Agni 5 has the capability if you require, because satellites, you roughly know locations, and Agni 5 can be used as an anti-satellite weapon. It's a heavyweight weapon, like using a sledgehammer against a fly.
You said it correctly, but you have any ballistic which normally goes for 1,000 kilometers plus height-wise, any of them can be utilized. It's not necessarily to Agni 5.